You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com. In this part of exercise 3, the introduction to Mocha's planar tracker, we're going to be looking at some different forms of motion and how we can properly set up Mocha's tracker to handle it. If you're following along with the footage, we are in exercise 03, introduction to Mocha's planar tracker, and I'm in the working composition. And I've applied the Mocha effect, and let's just open that up. If you're not in the Essentials workspace already, come into the Essentials workspace now, because we don't need any of the other distractions. And I'm going to come into my view, and I'm going to zoom to fit. So we have as much real estate given over to the viewer as possible. And we'll press play at the bottom of the viewer and take a look at our shot. Right, so we have a playing card that we're going to try to track in. And let's look at the best ways to do that. Now, when I'm creating a shape for tracking, there's a couple of things we have to think about. The first thing is obviously, what are we tracking? And this is actually a slightly different question than what you might actually think, because what we want to end up with at the end of this is the ability to replace the picture here. But that doesn't get to the real question of what do we have to track? And this is a bigger, probably more important question to ask yourself. And to answer this, the first thing we want is to find the best place to start our track. And the best place to start our track is where we have a nice in-focus area to track in. So this is a great place. This frame, if we look down at the bottom, 1 second, 24 frames in, is a great place to start. If we go back a little bit, 109, there's a fair amount of motion blur. This probably isn't the best place to start. And if we go to frame 23, there's even more motion blur. This is an even worse place to start, because if we have a look at the edge, you'll see the nice crisp border is actually disappeared underneath all of the motion blur. So let's come to the frame where it's nice and sharp. And this is where we want to start. The next thing to do is to draw our shape to choose what we are actually going to be tracking. And we're going to compare and contrast a couple of different ways of managing this. Now I'm going to come up to the top of the toolbar, and these five buttons let us draw different shapes to then track. I'm going to use this rectangular X-spline tool to generate up a rectangular X-spline. Now there's a couple of different ways that we can do this. We can make our shape as big or maybe even bigger than the area we want to end up with. So something like this here. There we go. So we've got the card plus a little bit of border around it. And we have a little bit of the fingerboard there. The important thing to do is that we're drawing the shape around a coplanar area. Remember from last exercise. So this is our big track. Now this is where it gets a little interesting. And before we even hit any of these buttons here, our track option buttons, there's one other thing that we need to reiterate. And that's the separation between this shape that we're tracking and the tracking data we end up with. Mocha's designed to be able to do many different things. One of them is to create nice roto splines, so mask shapes basically. And that's when having this shape as accurate as possible is most important. The other big thing is to get tracking data out of it. And that's when this shape here, the one that we drew, actually isn't very relevant. Because this shape that we draw, we can keyframe and it will look very, very different. There is going to be underlying tracking data related to this layer. And the way that we see this, the way that we can visualize this in Mocha, is using the surface tool. And to turn on the surface tool, we're going to use this blue button. And this gives us our surface. So this is a four corner surface that shows us our planar surface. So remember, our planar surface is our 2D surface that is infinitely thin, but also stretches out in infinitely in that same plane. What this means for us here is that we can now set up our planar surface to check that our tracking is doing what it's meant to be doing. So I'm going to put the four corners of our planar surface
onto the four corners of our card, or the four corners on the inside of the card's picture. And if we look in the middle, we have another little crosshair, and that is the center of our surface. That's the center point. To go along with the surface, we also have the grid, which is this pink button next to the surface here. And the grid is an extension of this surface. We can't manipulate this grid on its own. The grid comes as part and parcel of the surface. So it's that extension of the planar surface that we can see using the grid. And this is a great way to check to see if our tracking is accurate. So now we have these in place, we can take a look at the track motion options, and we can decide what sort of motion we're going to be tracking. And we have translation, which is movement left and right, up and down, which is essentially what we have here. We have scale, rotation, skew, and perspective, which we're going to come to in later shots. So for now, I just want to turn off all the other things and only leave us translation. So to do that, we click these buttons. And these buttons work in a hierarchy. So if we only want to track translation, we click translation and that turns on there. If we want translation and rotation, we can turn on rotation here and we get scale for free. Mocha won't just track translation and rotation, you'll always get scale in there. When we get to perspective, if I turn perspective on, we're going to get skew in there as well. In fact, if I turn perspective on, we're going to get translation, scale, rotation, skew, and perspective all turned on. So if I just want to track in translation, I can click the scale button, turn that off, and then everything else turns off as well. Underneath that, we have our track forwards and track backwards buttons. As you can see, our starting point was not at the beginning or end of the clip, so we're going to need to track in both directions. So I'll start by tracking backwards. And you can see we've tracked in those frames because those frames have turned blue and the rest of them are red. Now let's look at this. If we take a look at the four corner points of our surface, at our start frame and at our end frame, you can see that they don't match up now anymore. And you might think that that is a sign of a bad track, and often it is, but not necessarily in this case. Let's come back to our start frame again, which is here, and take a look at where the center point is in this. And that's just sort of above the center point of the Queen's belt. And let's come over to the start frame there. And you see the center point itself is pretty much in the same space. So why have these corner positions changed, yet the center position hasn't? Well, the reason for that's pretty simple. We've only tracked in translation. So we've only told Mocha to look for changes in the X and Y position. Now this card itself is subtly rotating a little bit, or subtly moving in a way that isn't directly related to X and Y position. Let's track this forwards and just take a look at this moves. You can see that my shape itself and the grid as well stays at the same angle. All that's changing is the position left and right, up and down, X and Y position. And this is the reason why when we finish tracking, you'll see that our center point is still pretty much centered where it was all the way through. So we are getting the tracked motion that we asked for, just X and Y translation. And depending on how we wanted to use this data, this might be good enough. If we didn't need rotation or scale, skew or perspective, this is going to be a good result. And it's managed to get that even though we've got a lot of motion blur on this card itself. So in this exercise, we've started on our journey into identifying what we should be looking at when we are setting up a track. We've then created our shape, set up our surface and our grid, and looked at the first of our track motion options, translation. I'm going to leave this exercise here for now, and when we come back, we're going to start looking at some of these other track motion options and when you'd want to start to use those. So join me in the next part of exercise 3, Introduction to Mocha's Planar Tracker, and I'll see you after the jump.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at BorisFX.com.